Well, good morning everyone. It's the 7th of April, a Thursday, and it's one of those rare days when I've actually got a day off work. So I've decided to go for a walk, and I've planned a short circular walk of 6.5 miles. I'll use this website. It's called two.a. Up there you can just see it. And it gives you an ordnance survey map on the left of the screen, and an aerial photograph on the right, which you can zoom in and out of. As you can see, when I move my mouse to this side, wherever I put the mouse pointer, it gives me a blue indication here as to where I am on the map, and vice versa. I'm on the map now with the mouse, and the blue indicator is showing me where I am. So this is my route. I should be starting my walk just here at the car park at Uffington, and if I click on that, the coordinates for the car park are SU29293 bearing 86530, and I shall walk up to the ridgeway, and that will be SU29476 bearing 85953. I shall then walk westwards towards Odston Barn. The grid reference will be SU27969 bearing 85123, and I shall walk southwards over Oddstone Down, and I should meet up with a track just down here, which is grid reference SU29650 bearing 82537, and then I go in a north easterly direction across Whitcombe, and I meet up with some gallops. The grid reference for that is SU30800 bearing 83818, and I then strike northwards along the gallops, and I meet these two interesting prehistoric burial mounds. They're quite strange actually. If I zoom in to one, the first one is at grid reference SU30338 bearing 84705. Anyway, you can zoom in onto that, and then you might get a better idea of what it looks like. Let's take that out of the way. And it's a kind of a disc burial chamber. Hope this comes out okay, because I'm just videoing my computer screen at the moment. Zoom back out again. There's the next one, which is not much further on, bearing grid reference SU30284 bearing 84873, and the walk then takes me in a northerly direction. Wait for the map to come on, but you can see from the ordnance survey side of things that I cross the ridgeway, and then I will walk to the centre of Uffington Castle and Iron Age Hill Fort. There's the white horse, the famous white horse is just here, look. And then I shall walk back to the car park there. Sorry about the screen being a bit slow to update. So that's my walk, a distance of 6.5 miles. I would have walked a bit further, but I'll have two small dogs with me. One dog likes to walk and the other one doesn't. Anyway, it'll be a good exercise for them. Right, let's get those coordinates loaded up onto the GPS, and then hopefully some footage as I go along. Well, I've loaded my waymarks into the GPS now and linked them together to form a route. So that's just a matter now of following the direction of the compass arrow. Here we are at the first waymark at the car park. Our way ahead is this way towards the Ridgeway. Lovely day. A couple of spectators. And here we have Uffington Castle, an Iron Age hill fort, to our left as we walk towards the Ridgeway. But our way ahead lies along this unmetalled road. At waymark 2, the path meets the ancient Ridgeway. We turn right, heading west towards Wayland Smithy. Looking back, we can see Uffington Castle now, about a mile in the distance, but our way lies forward towards Wayland Smithy. At this point, the Ridgeway comes across the ancient monument of Wayland Smithy, which is a burial chamber. Let's take a closer look. And here is Wayland Smithy, a long barrow. Let's look into the entrance of it. Lovely big tall beech trees around as well. Large stones mark the front of the long barrow. There's not much to see in here now, it's been blocked off, but I believe there were many burials in here at one point. Just a couple of dark openings at the front, but it would have gone back beyond that stone. And here's another view of Wayland Smithy from a different angle. Now we leave Wayland Smithy and continue our walk along the ancient Ridgeway to Oddstone Barn. Just past Wayland Smithy, we leave the ancient Ridgeway and take our route south at Oddstone Barn. And here is Oddstone Barn itself. Well, I'm about half a mile past Oddstone Barn, but I've met with an open expanse of ground which has been ploughed and planted with corn. So I'm not going to walk across the farmer's crop, I'm going to turn left, and I'm now heading in a easterly direction past an old wagon, well overgrown with ivy now. Anyway, I'll try and pick up the sat nav or GPS coordinates further on down this way. Well, I followed that track about 300 paces east, which took me parallel with the way I want to go. But now there's another track just here, which will bring me on the correct heading. My GPS. Oh, that's better. In the distance, I spot some deer. Browsing. Are they seeing me now? It's been quite pleasant walking around these parts. Vast acreages of corn, wheat. A lovely day. Beats being at work. Just walked past a nice piece of woodland. It'd be a nice place to set up a wild camp at some time in the future. Here's another view of that woodland that I just showed you. It seems to be part of an extended shelter belt of trees. There's an awful lot of this type of plantation in this area. So whether they're shelter belts or whether they're going to be used and harvested at some point, I'm not sure. So I've arrived now at waymark number 4, the track. But because I've done a detour, my waymark is actually 1/10 of a mile up there. But I know the route to waymark number 5 is that way. So I'm not going to walk to 4, I'm going to bypass that and just continue on to waymark 5.